Alright, what is up, my rebels? Mystic Umbreon 94 here, and today is episode... I'm going to sit up real quickly. Today is episode 6 of our Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Sky Let's Play. In the last episode, Chadwick gave us some pretty good advice, and we made our way down to... well, we actually got ourselves our own personal mission, actually, where we were assigned to go for the Waterfall Cave. And one of you guys in the comments warned me, Chiplup, actually, in my video describing how pissed off I was, you know, about the fact that the stupid episode wouldn't record. I fucked up the first time with the camera. Second time I fucked up because Camtasia crashed, and it was such a good recording too. But tonight, you know, since mom and dad are sleeping, like they got to get it for work and whatnot in the morning, I'm going to be a little bit more laid back. I don't want to upload tomorrow because it's going to be 2 days I didn't upload for you guys, and I find that that's really, really fucked up. So we're gonna record now, and God though, guys, I'm still mad though earlier because we had such a good thing going on with the commentary was great. I was freaking out a couple times, but you know tonight, you know, I'm still gonna be funny, but you know we're gonna have more of like a chill laid back time. Like we're gonna meet the chill side of Mystic for a change. You guys don't really get to see this all that often, but I mean. Yeah, we're about to do a little bit of a narration here, so let's, so this is the waterfall that's supposed to have a secret. Why would you run into the fucking waterfall like that? I know you're water type, but the water's crashing down at like 100 miles an hour. Why would you walk up in front of it? Chikorita, you're adorable. I'd kiss you on the cheek. Yeah, seriously. I would cuddle the fuck out of a Chikorita. But seriously, what Chikorita just pulled was like, stupid. Why? The water's pending down. Yeah, that's what I just said, Chikorita. Try getting close to the waterfall, Mystic. Why would you do that? Come on, character. This is incredible. I can barely stay near this deluge. And he's dumb enough to run into it after seeing what happened to her. And that's actually what happened in here. I'll tell you guys a story about this in a minute. About what I learned in philosophy class today. See? It's awesome. How's awesome when you get blown back like that? I don't understand Pokélogic anymore. If you fell into this waterfall, I think you'd get pretty battered up. I didn't think it would be pouring down this hard. That's what she said. Where should we even start looking? And it looks like my Torchic's getting another acid trip. What the hell's going on here? Something seems familiar. That's a dizziness I felt before. Acid trip. It's a cat. No. It's a cupcake. What is this creature? All right, see, there it goes. It's running in, running in. Okay, going into a cave. That was a weird acid trip, Mystic. It happened again. I know I shouldn't have done acid before I came to the waterfall. My nose is just like a bitch. Sorry about that, guys. Saw something, but what did I just see? Oh, what's the matter, Mystic? What, you had another vision? Another acid trip? I mean, vision? This time a Pokemon leaped into this waterfall, you saw that? And not only that, there was a hidden cave behind the waterfall. But it looks like the water is crashing down really hard. Well, yeah, no shit, you walked into it and you got fucking bashed. I mean, come on, Chikorita, like, have some common sense. Imagine if there was actually a solid cliff wall behind the waterfall. Eesh. If we tried to jump through, we'd be pounded badly. You'd think so. So, Mystic. What do you think, Mystic? Stop saying my name over and over and over again. You can just call me... I don't know. I understand what you're trying to say, Chikorita, but come on, chill out. Is there really something behind this waterfall? You're sure that there really is a cave there? Well, okay. I'm gonna believe you, Mystic. Yes, I totally believe in you, Mystic. So she's all enthusiastic now. Eek. Okay, I gotta be brave now. If I get scared and fail to leap through it at full speed, I'll be smushed no matter what I do. If I'm gonna go for it, it has to be without any hesitation. Be brave. Use all your courage. Go 300. Let's do this shit. Ready? Let's go, Mystic. 3, 2, 1, now! Freedom! Wah! Bonk. Yahoo! Okay, I think it's funny how they actually, like, do this. They shake their heads like, I'm all good, I'm all good, alright. What is this? Yes, it's a cave! Yeah, it's a cave. Very good observation, Chikorita. Are you sure that you didn't get a little bit bashed from hitting yourself in the head on the waterfall? Then again, my character has acid trips. I mean, I really can't talk neither, right? You're right after all, Mystic. Let's go explore this cave, Mystic. Let's see what the secret holds, Mystic. Mystic this, Mystic that. Good. Alright, I know it's my name, but seriously. Alright, guys, so, I'm actually going to get into a story that I had in Philosophy Quest today. We were actually analyzing a philosopher by the name of, I believe his name was, it wasn't David Hume, it was somebody else. I'm so bad because I can't even remember his name, but... Wait, yeah, it was David Hume. He's basically saying that that we have to experience factors in life before we can actually, you know, portray them into reasons and ideals. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that you... Did you just use rock slide? How the fuck does Lotad know rock slide? I ask Pokélogic and I just get bashed for it, but oh well. But yeah, this guy, basically trying to say, you know, we have to experience something before, you know, we can actually have, like, impressions. Or, I mean, we can have impressions, but we actually have to experience something in order to experience, you know, in order for us to actually, like, you know, tell, like what's going to happen to us. Like, for example, Chikorita hit itself by going down the waterfall. Odds are, again, you know, that's going to happen to us. Again. But, you know, sometimes, I mean, like, look what happened now. You know, we were actually able to go through the waterfall. You know, it really, really shocked me, you know, that we were actually able to get through the waterfall. Another reason is, oh, so I wants to join the team. Oh, no shit. Fuck yeah, dude. Join the team. We're going to call this guy, let's find a nickname for Psyduck. We'll call this guy... Fuck, Big Bill. Actually, no, wait. That's a girl Psyduck, huh? Derp Misty? I mean, I don't really know if this nickname's gonna be, like, good. But, I mean, like... I have no idea, but, you know, I guess we could try it. Derp Misty? I mean, it makes sense, right? Nah, actually, we don't need the female symbol, because it's obviously female. Oh, cool. So we, got a water type on the team. Chikorita actually grew up level 12. Learning a move. I believe it's synthesis, yeah. I've done this episode, like, you know, 3 to 4 times. Actually, 2 times, actually, so... Yeah, you leveled up. I know you leveled up, Chikorita. Good job. Alright, but... Yeah, about what I was saying before, about the, about experiencing things. Yeah, Torchic, you know, he went through the waterfall. And, you know, he experienced it. And that's how you experience things, you know, is by doing them in general. Okay, now I'm just talking to my ass. I'm too tired to speak. Let's just forget about what I went in Philosophy Quest today. I'm trying to concentrate, and I'm trying to kill off this stupid, thing. Okay. No, Chikorita, there's no need for you to, sit there and spam synthesis. Just use Rage Leaf. And now I'll talk about the, oh my god, yeah, Chiplup was right. Thank you, Chiplup, for that. Yeah, Chiplup, you were, definitely correct about me, running into Pokemon with Bubble Beam and whatnot from far away. Thanks for the warning. I completely forgot it. I mean, because, in my last prior to recordings, I never experienced the bubbles and Bubble Beams coming across from halfway across the map. And yeah, I'm definitely not going to fight you. Kiss my ass. There you go. Good job, Chikorita. That's why we have you around, with that quad-effective fucking typing. See, Chikorita does come in handy. Okay, okay. Through here. Alright, anyway, so you guys, in English class, we basically have to do a research paper. Actually, not even necessarily a research paper, more like, we had 5 different topics to choose from, and they all kind of have to do with, like, how America is, like, a packaged culture. And what we mean by packaged is that we as consumers view products more for what's on the outside more than what's on the inside. So say, for example, you know, a little kid, you know, he buys, you know, a brand new action figure. He really, really likes the design on the outside of the box. And I don't really give a fuck if Psyduck dies, because, like, I'm not going to go back and help his ass. Plus, I mean, like, we're right at the floor. We're okay, next floor. So yeah, basically what I was saying before is, you know, the kids, they actually, they're more interested in what's on the outside of the box, you know, or like what's seen on the TV commercials more than like what the actual product is. So say for example, you know, with Air Jordans, you know, Air Jordans say, you know, like you're gonna jump 10 times higher. No, you don't, because all Air Jordans do is they just make you look cool, and it really doesn't like really. I mean, yeah, they can help you out like on the basketball court, I guess, but I mean, you know, they're not gonna help you jump 10 times higher. And, you know, that's like how America, you know, that's how basically American culture and advertising actually fools us and kind of like manipulates us into buying these kinds of products, because I guess like. The producers of the product actually, you know, they manipulate us into thinking that we're getting a bigger bargain, you know, than we can chew on the actual commercial. I mean, then basically the people in who provide us with the advertisements fool us into buying the product, when honestly like half the advertising shit out there is just a bunch of bullshit. I mean, like, how many Billy Mays products, like, actually work, right? I mean, like, I guess OxiClean, like, works, but I mean, like, they blow things way out of proportion, like, when they say that these products are gonna do so much for us, but when in reality, like, the other day, me and, my buddy Scott, I don't know, Scott, if you're watching this, that's chill as fuck, dude. Welcome, thanks for watching the video, I really appreciate it. But a shout-out to my friend Scott, aka Pokemon Insider. We were talking the other day in a Skype call, and he was, mentioning me, to me, something about, I guess this putting system that you could sit down with. It was like early 2000s. Like, I cannot believe like idiots out there actually really fucking bought this piece of shit product. But it was basically like the potty putter. And basically, what you would do on the potty putter is say you'd be taking a shit, right? And literally, you could. Now I don't want to talk to you, derp. You could basically take a shit, and you could putt at the same exact time. And I'm thinking to myself, why the fuck would anyone buy this product? But, you know, idiots actually did buy this product, you know. America, you know, actually I'm not gonna say America, but the way that the Informatists, aka the producers, you know, like, they got these guys hook, line, sinker, you know, because it's like, oh, you know, like, it's, you know, it's gonna help out golfers and stuff like that. Well, I mean, I guess technically it does, but I mean, like, with such short drives towards, I mean, with the mat only being, you know, like, 2 feet, how in the hell are you gonna improve your drive, you know, when you putt? I mean, I know this from experience, because I was actually in junior golf maybe for like a year, and my grandpa is really into golf. He's like a really, really good amateur, and I also had a great grandpa who was actually a professional golfer back in the 1920s. So I just know, you know, from just past prior experience, that practicing on something so stupid isn't going to help your drive. I mean, yeah, I guess it could in a sense, you know, if you're like totally like new to golf, but I mean, you know, if you're like, you know, above like the amateur level, you know, how the hell is something like that retarded going to help you out? I understand. Oh, whatever, he's dead. Okay, I don't really care anymore. Can you just use Rizzleaf? Oh, you're out of PP. That sucks. Okay, hold on. No, wait. I got this. Put that seed on him. Damn it. Chikorita. Just tackle. I'm actually going to switch places with her. I don't really feel like doing this whole thing all over again, so let's just switch real quickly. I'll take the water gun. I don't really care at this point in time. I'm lucky that I missed. Alright, it's dead. Thank God. Whoopers can actually be really, really scary sometimes. Chikorita, get the fuck back here. There. Oh, that's right. Never mind. I forgot. Sometimes your speed can get dropped. What attack they're using? Icy Wind? I don't even know like what attack he uses anymore. My goodness. But yeah, those products, guys, they fool us hook, line, and sinker. I'll tell you that much right now. I'm trying to think of like a product on TV as like a kid that I bought, you know, like I was like really, really like surprised about when I got it back in the package. I know that there are products out there. Oh, Red Gummy, that's actually gonna help us out because we're a fire type. We'll get rid of throw these sticks, because, you know, fuck sticks. Sticks are stupid. Okay. I'm trying to think of a product as a kid that I bought, and I remember I was like super, super disappointed with it. Either that or like my mom bought it for me. Sock'em Boppers. I don't know if you guys remember Sock'em Boppers, but this is just from my experience. So I remember as a kid, I bought Sock'em Boppers. Oh, wait, was it Sock'em Boppers or was it something else? I remember Shrinky Dinks. That was another thing too. Oh, I remember something. Yeah. It was this product called Creepy Crawlers. And basically, what Creepy Crawlers were was they're these little insect bug things that you could put inside the machine. And basically, you would have like these little metal trays, and you would get out the little paint thingamajiggers. Thingamajiggers. The little paint bottles, and you would put in the color into the little pan, and you know you would like basically shape out on how you wanted your creature to look like. So I remember one time like I mixed you know like in like blue, red, green, black, and like a couple other colors, and so you know I'm like okay well you know on TV you know it made it seem like you know that all those colors were gonna come out. No, when I went into the fucking oven and I took it out an hour later, the stupid thing looked like a big giant pile of throw up. So that was like one of like the biggest products of like my youth that I fucking hated for that. Got another orange gummy, cool. Okay, I guess we can eat this apple, because technically, I guess we are getting hungry. Alright. Yeah, these stupid products though. And I was really, really disappointed with the Creepy Crawlers, just because, you know, it wasn't what I was expecting it to be on TV. And you know, the same actually kind of goes for, damn, there are actually a lot of products out there. Like Chia Pets. That was another one too, except I think Chia Pets actually worked. I don't even know anymore. But I mean, yeah, that's how America, you know, like, fools us into buying like all these different kinds of products. Wow, will you look at that, Mystic. Look at all the gems sparkling. Wow, look over there. It's a gigantic gem. Yeah, earlier I overreacted because of this moment, but honestly, I'm too tired to overreact. Basically, what I was saying was that all these gems in here, we can buy a Lamborghini, a Porsche, a mansion, but no, we can't. Everyone, yeah, well, technically, you know, we found it, so, you know, maybe it should be us, and you're a complete wuss. Come on, go Super Saiyan, get some fucking muscles, pull Barry Bonds, get steroids, I don't know. Pull out the fucking thing, though. That's $10 million worth of merchandise. We're stuck tight that. Oh my god, that's what she said again, dude. I'm sorry, I had to do that. That's just... Can I give it a try? You know, I guess I could. Pump up some steroids. Let's do this. This is really stuck, that's what she said. It won't budge. Oh god, my face. We got a tomato face status. Okay. Nope, no good. So you can move it either, Mystic. But we can't just give up. If we try hard enough, we'll probably get some kind of results. I'm gonna give it another go, Mystic. Pull, baby, pull. Fucking big old giant green leaf just like turns out Super Saiyan 3 energy just pops up. Green aura. It's not budging one bit. Oh no, he's having another acid trip. Oh no, I mean a vision, yeah. I don't support doing drugs at all on my channel, I'm just saying like he's doing. I say I'm saying he's having acid trip just because of the fact, you know, like this random crap happens, and like you would never like portray this if you were like sober. So it all almost makes it seem like he's having like an acid trip, like where he's like seeing like all this like random bullshit. And that doesn't look good for the for Mr. Cat Cupcake Boy. That was not good for him. The Pokemon, like, I know what Pokemon is. I mean, obviously, you guys can tell what Pokemon it is, but doesn't it kind of look like a cat and cupcake mixed together? I mean, I don't know about a cupcake, but I mean, maybe, you know, it's interesting on how these Pokemon designs actually came to be, and I'm actually kind of curious. Spectre, Ovi, or Scott, if you guys are watching this, where the fuck did... Say it again in a minute. I want you guys, you know, for theories, I want you guys just to start doing maybe more more Pokemon design origins. I think that would actually be really, really good for our collection. Like, maybe, like, once a week you guys could do something like, for example, where Dodrio's design came from. Like, that was actually last week. That was actually last episode where I recommended that. I think that would actually be really cool for the channel. Eck, that's. And, yep, there goes our $10 million. Good job. It's a flood! Yep, there you go. You fucked up our $10 million, Chikorita. Now how are we supposed to buy a mansion? Oh, that's right, I forgot. Now we can't even afford a Honda, you stupid bitch. Even though Chikorita's adorable, I'm just saying, I love Chikorita to death, but... You know what, dude? You just killed off $10 million. If only you guys could have seen my reaction earlier. So priceless. You guys would have laughed your asses off, but... Eh, fucking Camtasia and the piece of shit webcam Mike had to cut in the way, so I blame them. Huh? Where are we? Hi, hey, are you okay? You popped down from nowhere. Are you certain, everyone? Man, I was Spectre here. Spectre could do like a perfect Kermit the Frog voice. Where are we? This is the hot spring. Hot spring? Fucking old man voice. Indeed! I'll try. This is the hot spring! The hot spring works wonders on tired muscles and creaky joints, kinda like my old ass. Many Pokemon visit here. Tell me, youngster, have you your map?
Map? Oh, our wonder map, you mean. We have one.
Unfold it for me! There! We're here! This is a hot springs location!
Oh, okay. The waterfall's located here, so... Hey, check this out, Mystic. The water carried us all the way over here. That's cray-cray, dude.
My goodness! It was the water that carried you all the way this way? What a long journey that must have been! Let the hot spring wash away your fatigue before you make your way home!
Good idea, we'll do that. Thanks, everyone.
It's a very interesting little conversation. I kind of wish I was in a hot spring right now. Hot springs are so soothing, especially in like the spas and whatnot. I love going in my grandpa's spa, you know, just kind of like relax and chill out. And, you know, even sitting in like a shower full of like hot steam is actually good for you as well.
Let me see if I got this all straight. Beyond the waterfall, there was a cave. And the deepest part of the cave, there was a gigantic gem, which I would have totally taken from you if you guys wouldn't have gotten it. And I would have kept the money for myself because I'm a cheap fucking big nose beak bastard. Ha!
And surprisingly, you were flushed out the distant hot spring. Is that the distant enemy report?
Yes. That's awfully disappointing that we couldn't bring the gem back.
Yeah, we would have been rich, you dumb green. I love Chikorita. I can't insult her.
No. Empathetically, no. I think I'm so smart because I can use high vocabulary. Suck my frickin' beacon. Or whatever. Made a discovery.
Really?
Undoubtedly. After all, the presence of a cave behind the waterfall, no one knew about that before now.
Oh, I see. We made a discovery.
What I have is dizzy spells. Shut up the Pokemon I saw. Prior acid trip experience. There he goes again. Oh, bye-bye, cat. Don't cats like hate water? It's a cat cupcake. Which means the Pokemon is Wigglytuff. I mean, it's Wigglytuff. Sorry, my timing was off. Sorry, guys.
Your eyeball discoveries is amazing. The Go Master must be told.
So, guys.
Oh, what's the matter, Mystic?
So, guys, you know, when I was in Acid, you know, like, I tripped out, and I found that Wigglytuff is actually the one there, and it was in the past, yeah.
Pardon? You're saying that Wigglytuff may have gone to the waterfall before on an Acid trip? I mean, Mystic, you had a vision?
No, apathetically, no. Hail Giovanni, Macro, Hail Giovanni, Hail Giovanni. That's inconceivable. If that were so, the Guildmaster wouldn't have ordered you to investigate the place, right?
I don't know, dude. Like, I had an acid trip, dude. Like, I can't, you know, I can't deny it.
However, since you insist, I will confirm with the Guildmaster. But why would they want to spoil their own discovery? How strange. I should be used to it by now. These appearances are yet another strange current, aren't they? First, they're fucking stupid enough not to bring back the $10 million worth of gems that I would have kept for myself, obviously.
How about shove a shoe up your ass, shut up? How's that feel, huh? Nah, that money would have been ours. I would have quit this company, and I was sued you, that fat cupcake bastard, and that fucking loud ear-ripping Billy Mays. How's that sound? Yeah, I would have taken all the money for myself, just because I'm an asshole, you know? I like this game, though. This game's really cool.
What was that, shut up?
I'm nothing at all! Anyway, I will go confirm what you told me of the Guildmaster. Please wait here.
I see you, big dog.
So I had to go.
When I asked the Guildmaster, he mulled it over a bit, and then he said,
Oh, memories, memories, sweet memories, Utah.
Then he danced around a bit. And then he said,
Yes, yes, when I think hard, maybe I did go there once. Oh yeah, hillbilly talk, I'm just playing, I'm really tough, I'm a cupcake cat.
And that's just what the Guildmaster said. To sum it up, it's just as Messick suspected. He has indeed already been to Waterfall Cave. Oh, okay. That's kind of disappointing. We really thought we'd discover a new place. I wish Willy Tuff had told us right from the start. The Guildmaster can be rather erratic at times. I mean, he's always stuffing his face with cupcakes and big apples, you know. Well, that's too bad for you. Nevertheless, I shall expect your best effort tomorrow.
Yeah, taking my money again. I could have bought a Honda by now or some kind of bullshit. Fucker. Here they are, crunching and chewing. This guy's fucking playing with his apple. I didn't know cats were interested in apple. I thought that they were more interested towards, yarn and whatnot. But no, I guess this guy's after apples. I'm surprised he doesn't pleasure himself with cupcakes. Cupcake fetish, anyone? No. Good. You guys know I actually had this cream soda since like 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Same exact soda I fucked up on the recording at, too. Fucking kill this recording. Camtasia's better work this time or else I'm gonna be pissed off as hell. Today was exhausting. I actually got to sleep early. I feel it, dude. I'm gonna go to sleep now, but my buddy's actually coming over in like half hour. We're gonna like go eat, go probably get Del Taco, maybe In-N-Out. In-N-Out is like one of like the best fast food restaurants in California, by the way.
Sigh. Huh, we went through a lot today, didn't we? First we got gypped off of money, but you know, because I'm so retarded and we could have been rich, but now we're stuck back here at the bottom of the life, bottom of society, working for a big dumb-nosed bird, a loud fucking mouth, Billy Mays, and a big cupcake cat. Yep, we're so smart, Mystic, aren't we? But you know what? It was incredibly fun for me. Sure, there was that huge letdown, but it was our first exploration. I was ready to burst with excitement and anticipation the whole time. I realized I did the right thing becoming an exploration team member. One day, I'm sure I'll solve the secret of my relic fragment. That's my dream. If I ever came true, I'd surely faint from sheer happiness. Ha 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 ha!
I love you. Blushes.
You're welcome.
I can swear because of you, Mystic. Blushes again. I love you. I mean, yeah, Chikorita. Yeah, you're welcome. Not for real, though. If I had a Pokemon crush, it'd be Chikorita. Aren't Umbreon and Chikorita in the same friend group as well? Yeah, actually not friend group, field group, right? Yeah, yeah. Can they breed? I mean, I'm pretty positive they can. What, Chikorita and Umbreon? Isn't Chikorita in the field group? For sure, yeah. I'm the biggest chicken around, and even I managed to work up courage. And it was only because you heard me. Oh my god, you're making me blush, dude. Come on, man. You know, this Pokemon's a sweetheart.
Oh yeah, you know what I was thinking? I know something about your dizzy spells, Mystic. They always seem to happen when you're touching something.
Giggity?
Come to think of it, Fairy was right. I mean, when I heard Azurill scream.
Acid trips, dude. They happen anytime, anywhere. But apparently this guy, he touches shit and then he gets an acid trip. So basically, in a sense, he doesn't even need acid. He just touches things and he gets an acid trip.
I wonder what kind of power. I wonder what I'd actually be liking to have a power like that. I actually know, like, the name for this power, but I'm not saying shit.
I'm not gonna say nothing. I know some of you guys have actually played Mystery Dungeon before, but I'm not gonna say anything. And I know a guy in the PokeTube and chat I was talking today, because I was actually talking to a couple people outside, you know, of like my community, with like Ariza and all those other guys. But basically, this guy was like, "Pokemon Mystery Dungeon doesn't get enough views, JK." And I was like, "Well, you're a dumbass, because I mean, if you come down to our channel, the series is supported." Am I right, guys? I mean, come on. So, you know, we can fan tech the hell out of the like button today and at least score 20 likes, right? And like we always do. We've actually been really, really hitting up the like lately, but, you know, I want to go up to 20. I feel 20 is like a pretty good sufficient amount. I mean, you guys love Mystery Dungeon. Like, I mean, I am so surprised about the feedback that you guys have been giving me for this series. This feedback is insane. You guys love it. I love doing it, too. So, you know, like, if I can make both sides of the audience happy... I wanted to take a break from Nuzlocke so bad. You guys have like no idea, because I mean, Nuzlockes are fantastic, guys. Don't get me wrong, but you know, sometimes they just get to be like a real, real big heartache. Nuzlockes are just like, I don't know. They're fun. Don't get me wrong, but you know, it's just
It's nice to take a break, and me and Arezzo are going to have Sacred Gold up tomorrow on his channel. I haven't been recording with him this week because I've been busy of junk, you know, with my own channel, getting things ready for Team Eclipse. But an episode of, hopefully it'll be up by Saturday or maybe tomorrow. Probably Saturday, though, more than likely. I do apologize to you guys. Series will commence. And apparently I hit my head on the waterfall again. I'm not gonna commentate this because, I mean, voiceover, because, like, there really isn't a point. Now I'll voiceover. It's true. It was always after touching something. That's when I got those dizzy spells. When I see something connected to it. Right. There's another thing. When I rescued Azura, he had a vision of the future. This time he saw Wigglytuff going into the cave, right? So that means... This time you saw something that took place in the past. That's true. In other words, Mystic, if you touch something, you see its past or future. You must have that kind of special ability. This could be something totally amazing, having acid trips and touching things. Oh my god, I want that ability too. What's it like to do drugs, Mystic? I don't promote drug use on my channel. This guy's magical powers are saying... You could use it in a lot of different ways. Not just for exploring, either. The ability could be useful for many things. It's amazing, Mystic. Well, yes, I guess it's true. That doesn't mean I always get a vision every time I see something. It would be useful if I could have visions when I wanted, but... Yeah, you know, it actually would be kind of cool.
Hey, you two! The Guildmaster wants to see you right away. Guildmaster, I found your team rebellious.
He's hoarding cupcakes. He's probably, like, smashing up the cupcakes, and he's probably, like, fucking, like, sorting it like cocaine. He's a fucking cupcake... addict.
Hiya! Your team went through a lot today. Yes, a lot. But don't worry, I'm keeping watch on your activities. I should tell you why I called you here. We're planning tonight a full expedition soon.
Mount.
An expedition?
I actually have a funny joke, but I'll save it for later. Plus, we're running out of time.
Yes, the Guild want to go explore someplace far away. It's much harder than exploring our nearby area. That's why we need to prepare for the big trip properly. We carefully choose which Guild members go on the expedition. Really?
Usually, we never ever consider working as extradition members, but you two are working so very hard. That's why we're making a special exception this time. We decided to include you in the list of candidates for the expedition.
Really? I mean, really? Now. You haven't been chosen as expedition members yet. There is still time before we send on the expedition. If you fail to do work before then, you cannot expect to be selected for the expedition.
I'm sure you two can do it. Try hard! Giggity.
Yep. An exhibition, isn't it fantastic, Mystic? My pulse is racing all of a sudden. We get to be in the same tent together.
I didn't answer anything about that. I don't know about you guys. You guys didn't hear shit.
Let's try our best to make sure we got picked for the expedition.
Yeah! Alright, we got it, guys. Alright, cool. Chapter 6, Team Skull. The next morning... Oh, for the love of God.
Hi, Billy Mays here to wake you the fuck up. If you don't wake up right now within the next 10 seconds, I'll give you triple the offer, and I'll make sure that you don't have dinner, breakfast, or lunch. Absolutely nothing guaranteed for the next 3 days. So if you don't wake up right now, I'm gonna fucking scream and give you even more ear rape. Wake up right now!
Good morning, Mystic. I have been ear raped again.
You guys know damn well I would totally scream, but, like, I have, like, parents trying to sleep, and my dad would come in the room and be like, hey, fucking Billy May, shut the fuck up or else I'll kick your ass, and I'm trying to sleep, and, like, you don't wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning, because my dad actually works at Disneyland, and he has to wake up at, like, 3 o'clock in the morning every single day. Man's a hard worker, great guy, love my dad. Anyways, let's go back. Alright, you guys, so I think that's actually going to end up today's episode. We're about, let's see how much time we have left. Yeah, okay, we're about 34 minutes. That's actually not a bad time to end off that. But anyways, you guys, I'd say it's pretty much going to end up today's episode. If you guys liked the video, please be sure to faint attack the hell out of the like button and subscribe if you guys are new to my channel. I'm sorry for the late upload, you guys, but my English class goes on for a while, and, things will... I'll have an episode tomorrow, but after tonight, I promise you guys. Anyways, you guys, thanks so much for coming out here. Love you guys. You guys are an amazing audience. And above all, guys, be sure to always keep it rebellious. Peace out, guys. I'm out.